Hey guys, it's Kevin. Today we're going to work on a capping station that's really wet. If you do the self-cleaning, you can see it regurgitate and just spill out backwards. Let's check the plumbing first. So in the back of the printer, there's a waste tube. So we pick up the waste tube and we start sucking from the waste tube. That will tell us if the capping station is clogged or not. See? I'm totally drawing vacuum, so this capping station is clogged. We're gonna take the capping station out and clean it. Many times, especially after you put a new printhead in, you need to use self-cleaning to suck ink from the printhead to prime it. A lot of time you think the printhead is not working or clogged. Actually, it's not. The printhead is just fine, but your capping station is clogged. For this printer, we're going to take the capping station out and clog the capping station before we install a new printhead. These are just a few things you have to do before you install a new printhead. Check the capping station, check the F10 or F1 fuse on the mainboard, and check the driver chip on the mainboard. Check the FFC cable before you install the printhead. All of those videos are in my channel, so I won't repeat here. Okay, that pump is gone. We're going to uninstall the capping station. Many of you don't have this bar, but this one has it, so we're going to uninstall this bar first. So this is the first screw. Here's the second screw. Remove this support bar. Screw number three is hidden inside there. Here's a better angle. So you'll need a long screwdriver to remove it. By the way, I record this in the lab, so there'll be some background noises and beepings. Number four is from the top of the capping station. Number five is from the side. I'm going to explain this one after we unclog it, when we install it back, and I'll show you why this little metal piece is important. Here's number six. Number six, it got attached with two ground wires. So when you install back, don't forget you got two ground wires on this screw. Number seven is also in a hole. And from outside, you can see there's a screw outside. And easy to see, it's actually underneath that screw. That's where number seven is. After this screw, the waste station is totally free. You can move it back and forth. However, it got two things to stop it. One is the rail. Another one is the wire coming out of the capping station. Now we need to unplug the wire. Luckily, we don't have to remove the whole duplexer. We just have to loosen it. So remove those two screws. And on the right side, there's one screw on the top. Now the duplexer is loosened. Sorry, out of camera. This plastic, there's a tab here, and just hold on the tab, then let's see the other side, it's clear. So see this tab, and just loosen it like this. Then you just jiggle it a little bit, so you can remove this whole plate. So you remove that tab, just jiggle, and this tab comes off. Now you can remove those plastic tabs and you can just put forces. You don't need those tabs anymore. And remember the plug is a black plug and the socket is black too. So black to black. Both wire removed. One is the power wire and another one is the ground wire, orange ground wire. Now the only thing stop us is the rail. Remove those three screws from the rail. Now you can lift up the rail and take the capping station out. Now let's take a look. Just in case, we might need to take this whole thing apart. So before take it apart, we're gonna turn the gear in the back. We push it up all the way. When you push the gear all the way in the back, this wiper raised up. And the whole thing is locked. If you peek in, you can see a blue dot made by Epson. So we're going to mark both sides of the gear. We just make sure that it's marked. Sometimes the absence of blue dot wears off. So when you assemble, you don't know how to line up the gears. Whenever you have a cabin station, this first thing you do is raising up the wiper and mark it. Okay, let's check it. And this wiper, you can see there are lots of ink there. The wiper is used to wipe the bottom of the printhead. So if you have excessive ink, it gets cleaned. This wiper, just like a windshield wiper, it needs to be even. So if you have a dry ink like this, it cannot wipe the printhead clean, and you also can't get the streaks. So this is why sometimes you get streaks. It's not because the printhead is clogged, it's because this wiper is malfunctioning. There are two black tubes coming out from the center platform. The left tube is the ink tube. It sucks ink from the center. So we're gonna disconnect it from the manifold, and we can check if it's clogged from the center platform to the tube. You can see it's drawing vacuum. This tube is clogged. This tube on the right is the air tube. I mark it in blue. The end of the air tube is connected to this white assembly. So you can see if I push in the lever, the light open. So the printer sucks ink from this air tube. When you do this, I clean the platform rather than sucking ink from the printhead. So normally the white lever is out, so the air tube is closed and you suck ink from the printhead. So this is basically just a switch. It's controlled the white assembly. And normally the air tube won't clog, so we're going to focus on this ink tube. The ink tube is on the left. To check the center assembly, we're going to remove this little spring. This spring is very easy to get lost. If you lost it, you can go to bchtechnology.com. We're going to search for a little spring, and it's right here. Now push the front end of the platform. When you push down all the way, you can turn it to the left, and now the platform can be removed, and remove the spring underneath. You can see the two tubes still attached. The right side is the air tube. The left side is the ink tube. I'll take this, put it under tap water, and wash it. On the platform, there's a ring of rubber that's going to seal the printhead. If I have dry ink, that hardens the structure. It will not create a vacuum. Therefore, you cannot suck ink effectively from the printhead. Now we're going to remove this hardened ink. Also on the surface, we're going to find if there are any blobs, like a patch of dried ink, is going to affect it, suck certain colors. And therefore, some color works, some color doesn't. And this may be the cause. It looks like shit, but it's good shit. Okay, so now we try to see if those tube openings are working. So yeah, this is not clogged, and this is not clogged. Okay, this is good. Because we already know that there's a clog from the platform to the tube. So now it must be the black tube is clogged. Now we'll take a rod and clog the tube. And look at that. How about this? Very rubbery. Since we're already here, we also check the air tube, make sure the air tube is not clogged. So attach air tube to the syringe, and remember we need to push this white lever in to open the air hole. Okay, see, the air tube is good. Okay, let's take a look of this manifold. So the ink tube connects here, and then it's split into two tubes. The two tubes go in to the peristaltic pump, and then the pump spit out the waste ink this manifold and combine into the one tube. This one big tube is going to the waste tank. You can see there's still a clog somewhere in here. I can see lots of dried clogs inside those big white tubes. I need to clean inside the peristaltic pump to take everything apart and clean every single tube. I have another video that shows you how to disassemble the whole thing down to every single gear and how to put it back. To see how it's done, you can go to bchtechnology.com and search for L1800 capping. And you're going to see this is the video for capping station assemble and disassemble. However, before you totally disassemble it, you might want to start checking the manifold. There are lots of clogs in the big tube. However, most of the time, it doesn't clog completely inside the big tube. And you can see the blue dots inside the tube. Those clogs, you need to remove it. However, you don't have to remove right now. If you rush on time, you can check if the hard clog is inside the manifold. And you can unclog the manifold and get the thing working. You might eventually need to disassemble the capping station and clean all the tubes inside. Do not think the ink can flush out the clogs. It's like a kitchen clog. It cannot unclog itself by pouring more water. So eventually you're going to do it, but you don't have to today. So we're going to remove those tube clamps and just twist it and slide it back. We're going to check the tubes inside. It's a little bit resistant and this one's really good. I would say it's about 95% functioning. So I'm not going to fix it today. I will just unclog the manifold. You can see there are lots of clogs inside. The side with three large tubes and we call the ink outlet. That's where the pump spit out the ink. That one is very easy to unclog. What's difficult is this part, the small tube where the ink sucked from the platform. And this one is almost impossible to completely unclog because the inside is so small. I try to blow some air, try to blow it out. And you can see it doesn't work. It's still clogged. No matter what I do, it's just so stubborn. It's still in there. I'm going to give up after a while. I got some water and moisturize it. Hope it can help it get out. Eventually, I get one side working, but another side is just still completely clogged. Time for a new manifold. So we go to bchtechnologies.com and search for L1800 manifold. Okay, right here. It has a hook on the top. We're going to connect the two bottom tubes and we choose the two short tubes. You don't need the clamps anymore. We designed this connector to be larger, so you can just slide it in without using the clamps. Now attach the hooks under the top groove. And now you push it in, and it's going to lock underneath. Make sure you don't obstruct the opening of the air hole, so you slide this a little bit and make sure that it's not in the way. Okay, this will look good. Now we connect the black tube to the bottom. So now three tubes on the bottom are connected. And remember the ink flow from the platform to the bottom and split into two big tubes. That goes into the peristaltic pump. All the ink intake is connected. Now we connect the top three tubes. And remember, you don't need the clamps anymore. You can just remove them. Now we're going to check it. It's looking pretty good. Now we install the big spring. It sort of have a wire in the middle. So that's how you match it up and put it there. And the platform, you need to attach the tube first. Remember, the left is in tube and the right is air tube. The platform, it kind of have two short legs on the back, so you slide those two in first. And then in the front, there's one big tab. So you push it from the left side all the way down, then you slide to the middle. Now it's working. And then you install the little spring. And check again. So when we install, we just go backwards and slide this capping station in. I'm connecting the wastesink outlet. This big tube, I connect to the tube extension, so waste tube go all the way to the back. And I connect to the main board. And that really long piece of plastic plate, I normally don't put it back. Just put the screws on the duplexer, so duplexer will not be wobbly. I'm putting the screw 6 and 7 back. Remember, number 6 has two ground wires. I put the screws back to the rail. The capping station is still wobbly. You remember there's one screw that to top down from the capping station. You cannot find the screw hole there because it's on this plate. So you have to put this plate first. See, that's where the screw hole is. You have to install this metal plate first. And then after you install this plate, now you can see there's a screw hole underneath the capping station. Again, before you put the screw back, slide the capping station a little bit and make sure that the manifold is not in the way so your air hole can open. And lots of white, that's a good sign.
Hello, mortals. Your printer is saved. Kevin's YouTube channel is the answer to your prayers.
Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at w.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers.